If you look up gold in the dictionary, you'll see a picture of Ric Flair. And the 16-time world champion added an intercontinental title to his collection at age 56 when he bested Carlito in 2005. Highlights of Flair's six-month reign included a gruesome cage match against former best buddy Triple H and parties. Lots of parties.
The Nature Boy is gonna break down tonight and take it to Oklahoma City. All night long. Woo!
Everyone remembers that time Shawn Michaels introduced Marty Jannetty to a glass window. But did you know that Jannetty got sweet retribution in 1993 when he ended HBK's Intercontinental Championship reign on Raw? The good times didn't last, though, as Michaels won the title back from his former rocker teammate only a few weeks later at a live event. Albert could pancake the competition during his time in the ring, but the only championship he won during his in-ring career came in 2001, when Diamond Dallas Page helped him defeat Kane for the Intercontinental Championship. The reign was short-lived, and he soon lost the title to Lance Storm. It's hard to picture Road Dogg without the tag team title around his waist. He and Billy Gunn held tag team gold together for more than 500 days, but he's also a former Intercontinental Champion. Road Dogg won the title from Val Venus just 2 weeks before WrestleMania 15, where he retained the title in a fatal four-way. His reign ended the next night, though, against Goldust. And 2 weeks after that, Goldust lost the title to The Godfather. Don't blame Goldust for the loss, however. He wasn't prepared for The Godfather. The match was supposed to be Goldust versus Big Boss Man, but before the bout started, The Godfather offered a trade to the officer from Cobb County, Georgia. Boss Man gets a night with Godfather's friends, and Godfather gets Boss Man's title match. Everyone wins, well, except Goldust. He lost. Despite a few short reigns here and there, the Intercontinental Championship is steeped in tradition. It signaled the rise of some of sports entertainment's greatest stars like The Rock, Randy Orton, and Shawn Michaels. Who's next? I'm Tom Phillips. Thanks for joining me, and be sure to tune in next week for another edition of Five Things.